In this video, you will learn how to solve this nice Olympiad mathematics question. We're asked to solve for y in the value of 36 to the power of y minus 6 to the power of y equal to 30. As we solve this question, I want you to recall two laws of indices and also recall that 6 to the power of 2 can be equal to 36, right? Good. Now, if you know the law of indices, we have a to the power of x or to the power of y. This can be equal to a to the power of y multiplied by the power of x. So, we apply that law of indices and that factorization we've done will have this to now give us 6 to the power of 2 all to the power of y, right? Minus 6 to the power of y, and this will be equal to 30. So let's simplify for that. We'll simplify for that, applying that law of indices. We're going to have 6 to the power, this to become 6 to the power of y, all multiplied by 2, applying this law of indices, and this will be minus 6 to the power of y, and this will be equal to 30. Now you come to notice that something is common. We have 6 to the power of y. So let's let our 6 to the power of y to be equal to x in order to simplify that expression or equation. So this will give us x to the power of 2 minus x equal to 30. Now if we subtract 30 from both sides, we're going to have that expression to now give us x squared minus x minus 30, and then the right hand side will be equal to 0. So this is a full quadratic equation. So we have to solve this quadratic equation for the value of x. To solve this quadratic equation, we are going to look for two values we multiply that will give us negative 30. And when we add such two values, we are going to have negative 1. So what are those two values? Those two values, let's take those two values as 6 and what? 5, because 6 times 5 will give us 30. Now for us to have a negative 30, we need to put a negative here and also a positive here. Minus 6 times plus 5 is going to give us minus 30, right? So a negative 6, 6 carries negative because it is the greater value. So minus 6 plus 5 is going to give us a negative 1. So the two values we are going to have is minus 6 and plus 1. So let's put them into that expression. If we put them into that expression, we'll have the solution to now give us x to the power of 2 minus 6 to the power 6 multiplied by x plus 5x, and then minus 30, and this will be equal to 0. So you see, we have simplified that expression because this minus this will give us negative 1. So let's simplify for that. So we'll have our x common here, and then we'll have x minus 6, right? And then we'll have our plus 5 common here, and inside we'll have x minus 6, and this will be equal to 0. So we have x minus 6, which is common, and then we have x plus 5, and both expression will be equal to 0. Great. Now let's simplify this further. If we simplify this further, considering the first equation, we'll have the value of x minus 6 to be equal to 0, and then we can have the value of x plus 5 to be equal to 0. So from this side, we'll add 6 to both sides, we are going to have x minus 6 plus 6 equal to 0 plus 6. So this On the left hand side, we'll have our x left, and that will be equal to 6. From this other side, if we subtract 5 from both sides, we are going to have x plus 5 minus 5, and that will be equal to 0 minus 5. So from this side, our value will remain x, and this will be equal to negative 5. So we have to result our x is equal to 6, and then our x is equal to negative 5. Now recall that we said earlier on that the value of 6 to the power of y is equal to x. So if we use this expression here to solve this equation, we can be able to find the value of y. Now to find the value of y, let's assume on the other side that our x is equal to 6, we'll have the value of y to become 6y equal to 6. And you know 6 is also 6 to the power of 1. So because we have same base, according to the law of indices, our y will be equal to 1. So our y equal to 1 is the first solution. On the other side, we have our x equal to minus 5. So we have our 6 to the power of y to be equal to negative 5. Now for all values of y equal to negative 1, 0, 1, 2, this right hand side, this left hand side will give us always a positive result. Now for all values of y, this right hand will always give us a negative result. So positive cannot be equal to negative. As a result of that, mathematically, we'll neglect this result. So the value of y that satisfies that expression given to us is y equal to 1. Now let's check to see if our solution is right. The initial expression we are given that the value of 36 to the power of y minus 6y is equal to 30. Let's insert the value of y equal to 1 into that expression and see if we'll get the value of 36. Now, the initial equation will have 36 to the power of y minus 6 to the power of y. Will it give us 30? Now let's put the value of y equal to 1. So this will give us 36 to the power of 1 minus 6 to the power of 1. This will be equal to 36 minus 6. And what would that give us? 36 minus 6 will give us 30. So 30 on the right hand side is equal to 30 on the left hand side. And that tells us that y equal to 1 is a solution that truly satisfies the exponential equation we are giving up there. So you see, very easy. Don't forget to share this video with your friends and colleagues. Also, remember to give this video a thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel kindly for more simplified Olympiad mathematics solutions. Thanks so much for watching, and bye-bye for now.